How can I remove sin which is preventing me from marriage?
Remove sihr by asking Allah to remove it, and by taking the necessary steps in the kitab and the sunnah to remove sihr that may prevent you from getting married. Or with regards to jinn possession, the jinni is in love with the girl, he's in love with the guy. He causes the girl to say things, to do things, to act in a certain way which are repulsive to the potential husband, because he's jealous. He doesn't want another man to be with her, waliyadu billah. And this is very common among brothers and sisters. Many people, they call and they complain, say, I have a jinn. And the jinn comes every night, and I have to make a ghusl every day. I had a brother when we were in Medina who was in Yemen. He says, when I was in Yemen, he said, I had to make a ghusl every single morning. A female jinn will come to me and force me to have intercourse every single night. So when he wants to marry his sister, this jinniya, or this jinaya, as they say it in English, huh? I dream a genie. This jinni is going to behave like a real human being, like a jealous co-wife, a jealous girlfriend. She may cause him to move his face, or to say this, or to speak this, and do this, and twitch, and act crazy. He can't do certain things which keeps a real woman from being in his life. This is a reality. So if you have this problem, take the necessary steps in the kitab and in the sunnah. Seeking Allah's refuge, making the specific supplications, reading the specific surahs in the Quran and Kareem. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ آيَةُ الْكُرْسِي الْفَاتِحَ قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. The specific ayat that deal with ruqya, that deal with slaughtering the jinn, killing the jinn, removing sihr. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَيُبْطِلُ. Allah says, indeed Allah will undo it. Allah will unravel this sorcery. Allah Azza wa Jal does not. And Allah, he says, Allah does not allow what the mufsideen, the corruptors, people of corruption, he doesn't allow their things to be successful. He doesn't allow their plots to fall through, to finish through. So read these specific ayat, read these specific ahadith, read about the story of Suleiman and the Jews and this and that. Read the adhkar of the Prophet alayhi wasalam, and there are plenty of books in English, in Arabic, in Urdu, that pertain to the specific manners of ruqya. Doing it on yourself, someone doing it on you. And you have to be patient. There's no guarantee that it's gonna go away in one day. There's no guarantee it's gonna go away in 2 days. And if you are interested in marriage, tell the brother that you have a problem. The brother may be willing to help you out. He may be willing to help you out. He may be willing to fight with you. May the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And perhaps when you do get married, and it's a strong brother, perhaps the jinni will eventually leave. Everybody understand this? So that's a whole long lecture of the specific ways of removing sihr. You may not be able to remove the sihr yourself. You may not have the knowledge or the actual strength. You may need someone else to do it. Finding the actual piece of sihr, the amulet, the talisman, the tamima, the tiwala, finding the love potion, finding the letter, the grid, finding the acronym, finding the ball of hair, finding the comb, finding the underwear that was stolen from you. Someone took underwear from you and gave it to someone and put sihr because of the scent of your body on those clothes. And whenever you go somewhere, the jinn, they smell you like a hound dog. It's a reality, like a dog. A shirt that was on your body, you sweat, you perspire in the shirt, and they give it to the sahib, and the sahib gives it to the shayateen. And like a dog, you smell the scent, go track them down. Waliyadu billah. So finding the thing, finding the person to put the sihr, and doing the necessary actions, getting the product, destroying it, burning it, ripping it up, etc. This is in brief. Obviously, we don't have enough time to truly answer this question. Wallahu a'lam.